Today I'm going to teach you how to make an Arduino instrument. First, let's go over how it works. When you press on this sensor, which is called a force-sensitive resistor, the Arduino activates a distance measuring device known as an ultrasonic or sonar sensor. Depending on the ultrasonic sensor's measurements, the piezo buzzer will play different notes. It can play the notes middle C, D, E, F, G, A, and B. To actually play the instrument, you can use one hand to press the force-sensitive resistor and hold the other in front of the ultrasonic sensor. Now let's go over the materials we'll need to make this project. We'll need one ultrasonic sensor to measure distance, one piezo buzzer to produce sound, and either a button or a force-sensitive resistor to detect pressing. We'll also need one 10,000 ohm resistor, around 10 jumper wires, one Arduino board, and a breadboard. Now that we have all of our parts, we can start wiring. The electrical work on this project will be easiest if we take it component by component. First, let's just connect the positive channel to 5 volts and the negative channel to ground. Now attach an ultrasonic sensor to the breadboard. Connect the ground pin on the far left to the negative channel. Next, wire echo and trigger to digital pins. In this diagram, the echo pin is connected by the yellow wire and trigger by the green one. I used digital pin 11 for echo and 10 for trigger. Finally, attach the VCC pin to 5 volts. Now let's connect the piezo buzzer. Connect the positive lead of the buzzer to a digital pin. I used digital pin 12. Next, connect the ground lead to a negative channel. Now I can wire the force-sensitive resistor. Plug the component into the breadboard and use a wire to connect one lead of the component to an analog pin. I used A0. Then connect a 10,000 ohm resistor after the analog pin. Connect the other end of the resistor directly to the negative channel or with another jumper wire as seen in the diagram. Finally, connect a cable from the other lead of the force-sensitive resistor to the 5-volt channel. That wraps up the wiring. Now let's get into the code. First, let's define some integers. Set trig and echo as our corresponding pins, which in my case are 10 and 11. Next, define long integers for duration and distance, which will be used later for coding for ultrasonic sensors. Finally, set an integer called force, which will be used for the force-sensitive resistor. Now in void setup, we can define the echo pin as input and the trigger pin as output. Also, write serial begin in case you want to print anything for troubleshooting purposes. In void loop, we can begin by programming the ultrasonic sensor. Ultrasonic sensors measure the time that it takes for a sound wave to be emitted and reflect off of an object and back into the sensor. We can convert that duration into distance. Begin by setting trigger to low. Delay for 2 microseconds and then set trigger to high. Then wait 10 microseconds and set it back to low. To collect the data, we'll set the integer duration equal to pulse in echo high. Then, to convert the time, we set distance equal to duration divided by 2 times 0.0344. Now let's define some of the notes our instrument will play. We'll store the frequencies of the notes in an array, which we can access later in the code. To begin an array, we need to define its name. Let's call this one integer notes. Next, we need to define how many items are in an array. I'm planning on using 7 notes, so I'll write the number 7 enclosed in brackets. Now we need to write out all the frequencies of the notes that we want to use. To include the frequencies in the array, write an equal sign, then an open curly bracket. Now write the frequencies, separating each by a comma. When you're done, write a closed curly bracket and a semicolon. If you want to use other types of notes, you can find their frequencies online. I'll include a link in the description. Now let's code for the force-sensitive resistor. Let's set its integer force equal to analog read A0. Now we can use the integer force to call data from the force-sensitive resistor. Now we can get into the actual music playing. Let's start off with an if statement that goes over when to play a sound. You can write, if the distance is less than 0 centimeters, and or the distance is greater than 50 centimeters, and or the force is less than 100, then don't play a sound. To make the buzzer quiet, we can use the command notone 12. We want the buzzer to actually make noise when force is greater than 100. Let's write else if force greater than 100. Inside this else if statement, we can map the range of distance that we'll be using to the number of spots in the array. Write integer sound is equal to map distance 050, 07. To play the sound, write tone 12 notes bracket sound. 12 is the pin number of the buzzer, and note sound calls a specific note from the array. The note called varies on the distance read by the ultrasonic sensor. That wraps up all the code. Now you can upload the program and test it out. There's a link to the code in the description if you want to directly copy and paste it. If you don't have one of the components that I used in this video, you may be able to find a decent alternative. If you don't have the force-sensitive resistor, you can replace it with a simple push button. If you don't have an ultrasonic sensor, a photoresistor or a potentiometer would be a great alternative. The only component that I would say is pretty necessary is a piezo buzzer. I'll include links in the description to where you can buy all of the components that I used in this video. As always, if you have any questions, just leave a comment and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Thanks for watching!